Accidentally pressed the button twice. So I was planning to counterweight the gantry using the wheels from the original spindle and Z-axis, but the way I put the make a slide on actually doesn't correspond, so the T slot is at the bottom on this side if I move the camera around, and it's at the top on this side. Designing the machine this way was a little bit foolish of me, because the counterweight would have to take a lot more weight than had the axis been swapped around. I kind of like the idea of the machine being wider along the horizontal, but I've already cut the base out, the vertical stand, and it does look pretty cool. Had I not added holes into the X-axis maker slide to make that a little more sturdier, I could have possibly swapped the axes around. The problem I'm having is while I'm filming, I'm kind of coming up with new ideas, which isn't really a healthy way of filming, because the footage is very confusing. So I've added a bar across here, which is on the theatrical wire and the pulley system that I've just put in place. I'm not counterweighting the gantry yet, but what I have done is reduce the acceleration speed of the X axis and the Y axis, and that seems to have made a difference with the jerks when moving. The problem with the way I've installed the pulleys has resulted in having less space to actually move between the axes. The other problem I've realised is the counterweight will actually take up a lot of space and also restrict how much the machine can move. Without the gantry being properly counterweighted, if the stepper motors or the electricity or the USB connection happen to give way, and the gantry is at the top of the machine, it will crash to the bottom, and that has already happened to me a couple of times because of my connection on the laptop, and I've already broken a limit switch. So it's a really interesting problem trying to set up a CNC machine in an upright or diagonal position, but seeing as I haven't even managed to get it to work horizontally, I think I might try and achieve that first and then possibly experiment with this sometime in the future when I'm feeling a bit more confident.
In the next video, I will fit a moisture-resistant wasteboard to the CNC machine and attempt some test cuts.